continents, 30 cities, 32,000 miles. Nat and Kat, you have made amazing race history as the first all-female team to win the amazing race. And you have won the $1 million. Congratulations.
Back in her real life, Nat lives in the coastal city of Newport Beach, California. She's got a guy friend named Nate and a busy career as an MD specializing in pain management.
Hi, this is Dr. Strand.
Recently, Nat shared her story with DLife founder Howard Steinberg.
So during the race, did diabetes actually become a motivating factor for you that you have to get to the next level and you have to get through it because of the diabetes, not in spite of the diabetes?
I really wanted to show that you could do anything with diabetes. So when times were tough, it definitely did give me a little bit extra strength to draw upon. But in the moment to moment, I mean, as you know, diabetes is a huge pain. And, you know, there was moments where I was like, oh, I just want my pump to stop beeping, or I don't want to have to worry about a refill right now, or I don't have to worry about feeling extra tired because my blood sugar is high. But in the big picture, that strength and that desire to prove myself really gave me some extra spunk.
It makes you who you are, but at the same time, it's kind of, you have to drag it along with you.
Exactly.
Nat's been dragging her diabetes along since her diagnosis at age 12 in Scottsdale, Arizona. The Strand family was always drawn to outdoor life, and Nat and her brother Nick soaked it all in. But then the telltale symptoms began.
My first memory is driving on a road trip with my family and my dad saying, stop drinking so much, because we keep having to pull over to go to the bathroom, you know? And I remember kind of just being so thirsty. And I went to camp that summer. I came home and my parents took one look at me and knew something was wrong.
Despite her diagnosis, it's always been full speed ahead for Nat. These days, she balances the demands of her busy medical career with things like half marathons and extreme outdoor sports. But nothing could have completely prepared her for the amazing race.
I'm currently in probably the hardest situation for a type 1 diabetic on an insulin pump. The schedule's off, I don't know when I'm gonna eat.
3:37.
I knew that running the race as a diabetic was going to be a challenge.
But I've kind of gotten crafty at learning how to work our schedule to make sure that I'm safe and that I can do everything I want to do.
But despite her careful planning and undeniable superwoman status, the amazing race eventually plays on one of her deepest phobias, a major fear of heights.
What happened was we were in Norway.
Where's the next gondola?
We were taking this gondola up a pretty steep and very high mountainside. Now, I've watched the show enough to know that when you're taking a gondola up the side of a mountain in Norway, you're not coming down in the gondola most of the time.
We're just afraid of what might be waiting for us up top.
You're going down some other way that has to do with, you know, wings or cables or bungees.
Yes.
So I was really nervous.
Nat, you're fine. We're on a gondola. We're just on a gondola right now. Don't take yourself off.
And I don't know if everyone is this way, or if I'm just particularly sensitive to stress, but my blood sugar shoots through the roof with stress.
I think my nerves are making my blood sugar go up
a little bit high.
Fortunately, Nat and Kat had previously earned a free pass called a fast forward, allowing them to skip any sky-high stunts. At least for now.
Well, one question I get a lot is, well, production must have made some exceptions for you, right? And they did not. They don't make any exceptions for anybody. So I had to figure out, you know, when I'm in Ghana or in Oman, where it was pushing over 120 degrees, how am I going to keep my insulin cold? And then when I'm in the Arctic Circle, I'm going to keep it warm.
So in a way, diabetes in itself is an amazing race, and it's a metaphor for yourself and for being an inspiration for others. Do you feel an additional responsibility now as being a community spokesperson?
I kind of do. You know, I get embarrassed when my blood sugar is high, and I'm like, oh no, I can't. Yeah. You know, I'm supposed to be sending out this message, but at the same time, as you know, your diabetes is its own animal, and you do what you can to control it, but there's going to be days where it just misbehaves. Yeah. And the more you can interact in the community, I think the more you learn, the more inspired you are.
Nat's knowledge and confidence would be put to the test on the last day of the competition.
For what portion can I have my eyes closed?
And Nat would need to overcome her biggest fear for the sake of the team.
That was probably the most terrifying moment of my entire life.
Go!
There seems to be a lot of us who want to challenge their bodies and want to challenge the limits that diabetes could place on you. So yeah. There must be a reason why we're doing this.
Probably. I mean, when you become diabetic, all of a sudden, everything you hear is almost bad news. It's like, oh no, not only are you have to watch what you eat and what you do, but you know, you have to worry about your eyes, your kidney, your heart, your nervous system, your feet, infection. You know, all of a sudden it's like negative, negative, negative. And then I think you just probably want to show to yourself and just feel that, no, I'm healthy. You know, I want to go live a healthy life and be active. Diabetes is a challenge. It's not a limitation. As long as you rise to meet that challenge and you put your best effort in, it's not going to limit you in any way.
Being diabetic is just a huge part of who I am. And I'm so grateful to have run the whole race. And it means the world to me to show people that have diabetes that you can be as active as you want.